We were right in the middle of a big shop cleanout, and I had told myself that we were not going to do any projects until that was done. It really needed it. However, tragedy has struck. My little Buccaneers swash buckled. With Halloween approaching, clearly this is a priority, although some ways making a wood sword makes me fear for the furnishing and the pets and his friends and bystanders and the public in general. Yeah, sometimes you just gotta suck it up and make one for the little pirate. We're gonna go ahead and copy this sword. Now, this was made in China, I assume, from broken TV computers and like ground up orphans. And I actually kind of like the size and scale of it very well for him. And of course, he's got a little costume that's already been made to fit this sword. So we're going to duplicate that. I'm going to use some white hardwood. I think it's pallet lumber, but it's a really white, creamy hardwood for the blade. And then I'm going to sandwich with, I think, some cherry. That'll give the hilt some heft, some thickness, and I believe that the light and black contrast will be visually appealing. I thought I had a piece of cherry big enough to make this out of, but it turns out I'd have to glue some pieces together. What's this, bud?
Shipwreck.
Well, 2 years ago, we did a big family trip back east. Saw the Great Lakes. And my little man here, who's even more of a woodhound than I am, came screaming up to me right at dark, just as we were about to leave the lake, and said that he'd found a shipwreck. And so I humored him, and I went out there and looked at his find. And sure enough, there's like a 12-foot long black walnut plank. It probably was a 8x3 kind of plank. And it was, well, absolutely ancient. And so this has been our shipwreck wood, and I have been drying it ever since. Now, it looks to me like we're probably ready to try to make something out of it. The wood is shattered. This is probably a foolish thing to use a piece of treasured wood for, but, you know, to the mommy and the daddy, it's going to make that sword one of the neatest things and hopefully a relic of childhood. And to him, it might not mean much. I've done my best with a wire brush to scrub as much of the Great Lakes out of this board as I can. However, I think there's probably a fair bit of grit still left in this. And normally I would joint it, but the blades in the planer are just about trashed. So I'm gonna go ahead and see if I can plane it, because I figure those things are junk anyways at this point. So we're gonna see if we can get this to plane down reasonably flat, and then I'll try to get some pieces cut off on the table saw. Yeah, well, it's rocking. Daddy does not like the rocking on the table saw. So I'm gonna go ahead and try getting some flats first, then I'll make an attempt to square it up. I've waited for a long time to try to see what was inside that board. And definitely, we got us a good piece right through here. Nice and solid, I think. Look at that raise. You know, it might be a waste to use it on the sword, but he's gonna treasure it. That's why he's out here with me. He's just quivering. He's so excited. He's so excited that we're making something from the board he found. The shipwreck board he found. And then the fact that it's a pirate thing is extra special. So when it comes to this, I've got a little extra right here. And if I had that gone, then this would be relatively straight. Certainly straight enough to go into the table saw and get a first pass over here without binding. I'm really contemplating just taking the handsaw and shortening that little ledge right there up. Yeah, bud?
Can you cut these in half?
Yeah, but you're gonna have to wait. Okay, so I got that done. I got it sort of trimmed up to size. I mean, it even smells marshy. I have got a big old split in there, but it doesn't appear to go much beyond. Yeah, a little bit right there. Probably right here is the good stuff. You know, it's trying to find a balance between getting a piece big enough for what I want for his toy and the potential usefulness of this lumber maybe later on. So I'd rather work with the whole thing, but I don't want to cut the whole thing up into little pieces so that they're not super useful later on. There again, this is always going to be an accent wood. I think the handle could do with being a little thicker, but I don't want three times the thickness of this for the little hand. So I'm shooting for about a quarter of an inch off of each of these cheek plates here. The thing is, so I'm gonna go ahead and take a small bite first and I'll work my way up through in successive sizes. And so I'll cut it like this and then I'll cut it like this and eventually we'll meet there in the middle. And if that one comes off intact, it's possible that I can get both sides out of this right here without needing to cut it any further. Let's see. This face here is smooth enough with a little sanding to be our glue up. Why not?
Because you cannot glue it on here. You can make the sword out of that.
Can I?
Uh-huh. The sword top out of that. Dad, you have to make the sword top out of that. And not this one. You have to make the sword top out of that. Okay? Sword top. It's out of that small one.
Well, you might be a little disappointed because I think I'm going to go ahead and cut the sword top out of this piece. But you just got to trust your daddy. He knows what he's doing. Okay. One of the things I like about this sword is that this little detail right here, I think, adds a measure of unique realism. So I'm gonna come up with my own. And then I will cut this out. I don't want that. I don't want that. So I'll make a cut down here. And I'll make a cut down here. Stop. I said, no, Daddy might need that. Just give me a moment of quiet time, and then you can go back to being you. Big thumbs up, Halloween crisis averted. Once he was done playing with it, I did coat it in some water-based poly, you know, just in case it gets gnawed on or something, and that gives it just enough of a finish to take a bit of a polish with your hands.